Greetings from the Consumers Association of Penang. Today, I'll share with you the study we did to determine lead in paint in public playgrounds equipment in Malaysia. The urban pollution issues in Malaysia affects the air quality. And this has come about because of the rapid economic growth in our country, which had imposed costs in terms of industrial pollution and degradation of the public of the urban quality of life. According to a survey, the most concerning environmental issues in Malaysia is global warming, followed by air pollution. That includes from vehicles, industries, and also from haze. Since 1997, Malaysia was affected by the Southeast Asian haze caused by forest fire, resulting mainly from illegal burning for clearing oil palm plantations and peat fires. And this took place on the Indonesian islands of Sumatra and Kalimantan. During the haze period, unhealthy air pollution index readings were recorded in the country. Residents with asthma and pulmonary problems were told to stay indoors until the air quality in the areas improved. Our Malaysian aviation and maritime sectors were put on high alert following the reduced visibility caused by the haze. Schools were closed when the API reading surpassed 200. And the illegal dumping and burning of plastic waste has also led to dangerous levels of hazardous substances and chemicals in the Malaysian soil and water. A wide range of hazardous chemicals such as lead and cadmium and plastic-related chemicals, which are persistent in the environment, were also present in the samples. In the study, it was shown that toxic metals such as lead and cadmium were several times above the acceptable limits set by the Malaysian Department of Environment. This is of particular concern as they can cause irreversible damage to flora and fauna. Given the hazards associated with lead, CAP had conducted numerous tests on food and products for the presence of lead. Over the years, we found lead to be present in a wide range of products, such as paints, cosmetics, and food. Similar studies done by others has also found high levels of lead in Malaysian products. However, there's a dire need in the country for standards for lead in paint. And we had done the test earlier and we found that the levels of lead in most of the Malaysian paints had exceeded the international levels. And what is more concerning to the Malaysian population is that we do not have a standard for lead in paint. So the study actually helped us to generate data on lead concentration of paint in the normal paint as well in the playground equipment. And at the same time, we also wanted to raise public awareness about the presence of lead paint hazards in children's playground. So in August 2019, 10 playgrounds in Penang and Kedah states in Malaysia were visited. In each playground, painted play equipments were observed and documented. Samples of chipping paint were taken from 17 pieces of playground equipment and analyzed using a handheld SRF Olympus Delta series. And this test was actually done by the organization Earth in Bangkok. The study shows that paint chips from 13 out of 17 samples contain lead above 90 parts per million, out of which 11 samples contain 10,000 parts per million. The highest lead level detected was 620 parts per million in a yellow multi-layered playground equipment at the public playground in Georgetown, Penang. So in order to reach public outreach and also public awareness, we had published the results in the book called Lead in Playground Equipment in Malaysia. And at the same time, we also made posters and conducted press conferences. And we had also used social media to reach the public to create public awareness, and also the results of our test was also uploaded in our CAP website. This is the media coverage we had on the issue. As our country, we are a multiracial country, so it was actually publicized in three main languages, that is in Bahasa Malaysia, Chinese, and also in English. So we had a quite a good coverage. The media had carried it as it concerned children, and also it's also a topic that is of concern to the consumers. Besides that, we also had a talk to a woman's a group of women advocates, consumer advocates, to actually educate them on what is lead and what are the toxic impacts. And also we at the seminar we organized, we also exposed the data and what the housewives or the mothers need to know the dangers of lead that would affect their children. Besides that, we also wrote letters to the relevant authorities and municipalities. And following to it, the Malaysian Landscape Department of Penang Island City Council approached CAP for a discussion on a way forward in this matter. In the meeting, which was held on the 1st of November 2019, the department had several queries on new procurement abatement measures during removal of lead paint and disposal of scrap paint waste. After consulting IPEN, CAP wrote to them with some suggestion on the measures to be taken. The high lead levels found in painted playground facilities constitute a risk of lead exposure for children who spend time playing in this playground. So this was what we informed them, that how dangerous it is to our future generation. So what are the challenges that we face in Malaysia? There is no abatement measures or protocol for removal of paint in playground equipment. At the same time, the Malaysian government has been slow in formulating lead paint regulations and standards. And to date, the government has yet to identify the agency to formulate and enforce regulations. So what was our campaign outcome? Presently, there are regulations on lead only in food and cosmetics in the country. So what we need is the mandatory safety standards of maximum acceptable migration of lead in paint for not more than 90 parts in toys intended for children below 14 years old. This is what the present standard we have for lead, only in toys. However, the scope of the toy standard does not cover playground equipment. Also, it is unsuitable for this purpose since it does not take exposure routes in playground into account. So what we want as a conclusion is that we want the eliminating the source of lead exposure is needed to protect humans and nature from harmful effects of lead. At the same time, we need regulations and enforceable standards are needed so that we can stop the manufacture, sale and import of lead-containing paints, as this will have a long-term impact locally and globally. Thank you.